Hey everyone! Today we're going to take a look at playing PS5 or any game console on a computer. This will work on Mac, Windows, or even Linux. So let's dive right in. What you just saw before of me playing PS5 on my MacBook is made possible with a device called Shadowcast. It's a device that lets you plug any HDMI-capable device into your computer through a USB-C connection. This will let you record, stream, or just play games using your MacBook as the display. When I came across the Shadowcast on Kickstarter, I was intrigued by its low $40 price tag and wanted to check it out. So now that I finally got it, let's dive into an unboxing and in-depth look. Inside the package was actually two things. First, we've got the actual Shadowcast device. On the back, it seems to be showing all of the things it can do. It does say here on the back with the technical specifications that the HDMI input is 4K at 30 FPS or 1080p at 60 FPS. When I unwrapped the packaging, I had forgotten that I also chose to add on the covert dock. I'll set it aside and maybe make a video about it another time. So let's unwrap it and unbox it. Opening it up, the first thing I notice is the device, but then there's this big don't forget this cable, but it doesn't quite tell me what this cable is. Anyway, underneath the Shadowcast is a few more things. Another don't forget the cable piece of cardboard. A really nice looking USB-C cable. It's even got a 90 degree on one end. A Genki sticker. There's another sticker, not exactly sure what it is, looks like an alien or something. It's pretty cool though. An instruction manual, I'll put that aside just in case we need it later. And there you have it. Pretty good packaging. The Shadowcast itself, a super long USB-C cable, that cool extra sticker. Oh, and the don't forget the cable reminder. So first I wanted you guys to get another look at that USB-C cable because it's really nice. And there's another look at that one end that has the 90 degree angle on it. Let's pop out that Shadowcast and get a closer look. On one end you have the HDMI in, and on the other, a USB-C out. It's pretty light, but it feels really well made. Getting everything set up is pretty much plug and play. You download the app from the App Store if you're on macOS. They have a Windows app, and you can even go directly to arcade.genkythings.com. After you download the app, take out your console of choice, I'll use the PS5, get your Shadowcast, and a USB-C cable. Plug in the Shadowcast, then plug the USB-C cable into a computer, and then the Shadowcast into the other end. Then I'll launch the app, and move it into view here. Inside the settings of the app, you can change the mode to either have better resolution or better performance. There's microphone options for voiceover, and a default save directory. Other buttons here are to save a screenshot, turn on voiceover through a microphone, or record game footage. Alright, enough about the app, let's boot up my PS5 and take a look at some gameplay. So to test out some gameplay, we'll start with Astro's Playroom, then we'll play some Call of Duty, and finally, I'll show you some footage recorded through the Shadowcast app of Mario Kart on Switch. So you can see that Astro's Playroom really does feel like it's running great. Even though this is the free game that came with the system, it really is a ton of fun. We'll switch over to Call of Duty Cold War with some online multiplayer.
We've lost the hard point.
Overall, the game feels very playable on my MacBook, but when there's a lot going on, it just doesn't feel as smooth as playing on a TV. And to change things up, here's Mario Kart on the Switch. I recorded this footage using the record feature built into the Genki Arcade app, and it definitely looks pretty awesome and is very high quality. So, is the Shadowcast worth it? I'd say if you have any interest in recording gameplay or footage from an HDMI-capable device, $40 is a really great bargain for a device that works so easily and has a great companion application. If you're interested in buying a Shadowcast for yourself, I've got a link in the description of this video. That's it for today. If you enjoyed this video, like, share, subscribe, and all that stuff, and look out for more videos soon.